Hi, this is Dr. A. Continuing our basics of the lab series for hematology, we're going to look at polycythemia. So polycythemia is a condition in which the number of erythrocytes is increased, translated as there's a high red count on the CBC. Polycythemia is divided into three groups. There's polycythemia vera. It is a myeloproliferative disorder characterized by an increase in all of the cellular elements of the blood, meaning there is going to be more red cells, but also more of the white cells. So the bone marrow is simply on its own making more red cells, and it's really just too much. Then you have secondary polycythemia. So that would be an increase in the red cell mass, or so the amount of red cells in the bloodstream that is due to a physiologic stimulus. There's a couple of examples I can think of right off the bat. One is going to higher altitudes. So if you live at sea level and then you decide you're going to go visit Colorado or something, you're going up into mountains, what's going to happen is the pressures of oxygen change, and it's lower at a higher altitude, and that was going to stimulate an increased production in red cells to deal with that oxygen pressure difference in with the oxygen transport. And so, especially if you stay there for a little while, your red cell mass is going to increase when you're at a higher altitude. This is also behind some of the athletes like trying to live at higher altitudes so they get increased red cell production, but competing and training at lower altitudes so they can have an increased oxygen carrying capacity in their red cells and therefore more endurance. Another thing that I can think of for secondary polycythemia would be males that get testosterone replacement shots, or maybe they've have a low testosterone level and they get some supplemental testosterone. Well, one of the things that physician ought to monitor on a male that's getting testosterone shots is the red count, because that can cause an increase in the red cell mass. It can cause a secondary polycythemia, and so as a side effect of the increased testosterone from the injections. A relative polycythemia is when the red blood cell mass appears to be elevated, but is due to an underlying condition, but the red cell mass is actually normal. It could even be decreased. So this is where there is a relative loss of usually of like the water, the liquid component. And so severe dehydration would be a relative polycythemia. It's just the lack of the liquid, the lack of the water, it makes it look like there's more red cells than what actually is. Correct that, and the polycythemia goes away. Most of the health concerns associated with polycythemia vera are going to be caused by the blood thickening effect of all those red cells, and that can lead to heart attacks, strokes, and DVT. And so, incidentally, one of the risks of testosterone replacement in males is a heart attack, and part of that is due to that increased amount of red cells and thickening of the blood. One of the solutions, so this is if you have polycythemia vera, would be to donate red cells on a regular basis or do therapeutic phlebotomy. Obviously, if one is eligible, donating blood is great, because then you can also save some lives in the process. And if you're on testosterone replacement shot, who knows, maybe there would be a good way for you to avoid having some of the side effects of that by just simply becoming a regular blood donor. So there you go. That is all the basics of polycythemia. Thanks.